Engine Station on Space to Ground.
Welcome to Space to Ground, I'm Isidro Reyna. This week, the crew welcomed the Orbital ATK Cygnus cargo ship to the station. Dubbed the SS Gene Cernan after the last person to have walked on the moon, Cygnus launched into orbit to the International Space Station on an Antares rocket on November 12th, carrying nearly 7,400 pounds of crew supplies, equipment, and scientific research to support Expeditions 53 and 54 crew members. Cygnus was captured and bolted into place on the station's Earth-facing port of the Unity module on November 14th. The spacecraft will spend nearly 3 weeks attached to the station before departing in early December. One experiment delivered on Cygnus is the E. coli antimicrobial satellite, which could help us determine appropriate antibiotic dosages to protect astronaut health during long-duration missions. Antibiotic resistance could pose a danger to astronauts, especially since microgravity has been shown to weaken human immune response. The experiment will expose two strains of E. coli to three different doses of antibiotics. One of these strains is deficient in the gene responsible for the increased antibiotic resistance in microgravity. This week's Twitter question comes from Teresa Boyd. She wants to know who astronauts contact if they have a question about an experiment while on the station. Well, that's a great question. Astronauts can call down to Earth and connect with NASA's Payload Operations Integration Center in Huntsville, Alabama. The Payload Operations Integration Center is the heartbeat for station research operations. As NASA's primary space station science command post, the Payload Operations team coordinates all American, European, Japanese, and Canadian scientific and commercial experiments on the station, synchronizes payload activities of international partners, and directs communications between station crew members and researchers around the world with onboard experiments. Keep sending us your questions using the hashtag SpaceToGround. And for those educators out there, visit nasa.gov/stemonstation to find ways to get involved during NASA's Year of Education, a celebration of an almost 12-month presence of a teacher on board the International Space Station. We'll see you next week.
Subscribe for more space.